This here is an audio morph from Open Acoustic Devices. These devices are typically used for eco-acoustic applications as they can record ultrasound frequencies. However, they're useful in pretty much any application that involves recording over a large period of time. This particular unit is an audio morph 1.0, which has a bit of a problem in which the switch overhangs the PCB, which makes it very accessible and easy to use. However, it leaves the switch rather vulnerable to breaking off, like we see here on this one. And I should also mention that this is sometimes a problem with the SD card slot as well. If you have a particularly tight custom enclosure, it can snap the SD card. Now, this problem has been fixed on the Audio Morph 1.1 and the new 1.2. As you see here, the switch is recessed into the PCB, and a number of other improvements have also been made, such as lowering the noise floor and adding an external microphone jack. However, the old 1.0 PCB is still perfectly fine for pretty much all applications, so I'd like to fix this one here today and show you as well how to do it. There is actually a post on the Open Acoustics forum page about another person who's also fixed a broken switch. However, their approach involves taking off the battery holder, which requires you to desolder it. And, well, I don't particularly want to do that, and I imagine a lot of other people don't particularly want to have to desolder it as well. So I'm going to show you here how to do it without desoldering anything. This here is the switch that's used on the audio morph. It's a Nidec Copal Series CSS1310. You can get this from pretty much any electronics component supplier, such as DigiKey or Farnell or Element 14 or Mauser, and in some cases you can even find it on eBay. So I'll leave some links in the description below if you want to get them. Just keep in mind that wherever you are in the world, shipping might be more expensive than the switches themselves, so shop around. Now, if we take a look at the switch, we can see that there's three major components to it. There's the plastic black body, as well as the white sliding element, along with a metal clip that retains this. We want to unclip this metal retaining bracket, and we can do this by just putting in a metal spudger underneath the clip and levering it up on either sides, and then just pulling it out like this. And today we're going to use both the slider nub as well as the metal retaining bracket. However, don't throw out the plastic black body, just in case you need it one day, put it back with the other switches. Now, to remove the old switch, we have to remove this bracket. However, it's very difficult to try and unclip it, so we're going to try and cut it in half. So I've just got a pair of old tweezers that I don't care about bending, and I'm going to shove it in here and bend up, so that we can cut it in half. And now that I've bent it up sufficiently, I can just cut it with a pair of side cutters. And with it cut, I can get a lot more leverage on it with the side cutters now, so I can pull it up even further and get the other side up where I can cut it. And that I'll also just cut pretty much the same. And now if it cut, it's much easier to just remove it. And we can remove both parts and remove the sliding element. And this is also a good opportunity to give it a little bit of a clean as well. Now, in order to get the new metal bracket on, you'll notice that there's two little pins at the bottom. These are to give it some extra strength and hold it in place. However, we're not going to be able to put that on because it's already mounted to the PCB and the battery holder is in the way. So we're just going to cut it off with a pair of side cutters. Now, this thing is, I'm pretty sure it's made of steel, so it is actually rather difficult to cut. So you probably don't want to use your good pair of side cutters. And make sure when you do cut them to cover them with your fingers so that the pieces of metal don't go flying into your eye or somewhere around the room. Now, with all that done, it's just a matter of putting the switch back together. So you can just drop the new sliding element back in, and then you can put the metal bracket back on top. And push down on it, and you'll hear two distinctive clicks to know it's locked in place. And that's pretty much it. Should be good to go. We can see the switch works perfectly now. So, as always, thanks for watching.